you really started out, your intentions were really small, you know, just doing what was going on in your community.
Right.
But then what were you thinking when you realized it went global? That, you know, just because of a few tweets and a few conversations, all of a sudden you've got this thing that's really huge.
Mm-hmm. Well, it got out of control really quickly. Which is what happens sometimes when you put your hand up in the global community and when you ask for people to contribute their time and their stories. There's so much goodwill. There's so much interest in doing that. I'm always fascinated to hear everyone's story, anyone's story, in terms of open educators and people involved in the open community. So, I kind of forgot that can happen. So it really got crazy, but which is really great.
Was there anything that really surprised you during your 24-hour marathon about this, the whole event for Open Education Week?
Well, I mean, I was definitely completely blown away by the quality of the presenters and the presentations and the topics and the conversations. Everyone was amazing. There was, there wasn't a bad conversation. There wasn't an awkward pause. There wasn't, everyone was really engaged and really had very important and great things to say about the work they were doing. So, I was surprised by that because, as I say, when you put something together like this in a very short time window, you have no idea what to expect.
Right, right.
And I was blown away. It was amazing. I was also really grateful and humbled, as I always am, by people's willingness to support and help and volunteer. So all kinds of crazy hours of the day and night, people were hosting. So Cable Green was one of the hosts. Ken Bauer was one of the hosts from Mexico. Stephen Downs agreed to do some hosting. So talking about other languages, we had Louisa from, I just want to make sure I get her organization right, from Charisma, hosting sessions in Spanish. So that was really great. And again, that's just exactly the kind of connection that I'm hoping for and looking for. We had Cosmin Herman, and I'm just trying to remember what language. I just want to get this right too. He wanted to present in Romanian. So I did ask, you don't have to present in English. What language would you like to present in? So we had three presentations in Spanish. We had Cosmin in Romanian. So I'd love to see more of that. But it's a little tricky to kind of get rolling and get started with that if it's not your language. But it all worked out, in really amazing ways. The thing that surprised me most was the realization, a couple of realizations in the moment on the day of. I was, paying attention early on because it started in my evening. Essentially, we were going midnight to midnight GMT, essentially. So it started in my evening, and as things got rolling, there was a tiny technical glitch. And I thought, oh my gosh, I'm the only one that has a link to this whole thing. And if I don't pay attention for all the 24 hours, if it goes down, there's no one that can fix it except me. And I hadn't really, because I had hosts lined up. And as I say, very generous people willing to do, take over the feed and do. But it turned out I was the only person that was the keeper of the feed. And so that became very tricky. I had to stay up for 24 hours. I catnapped here and there. I wasn't expecting that. And I didn't plan for it, but it turned out okay, and I was able to do it. I was a little tired the next day. I can definitely vouch for that. But what an adventure! And then also, in the links for presentations in other languages, it didn't occur to me that I couldn't use the same link that I had advertised everywhere for multiple things at once. And so my colleagues from eCampus Ontario, who also have Zoom links, jumped in to save the day. And as always, they're extremely amazing. And even someone from Zoom, we had to call in somebody from Zoom to transfer the technology, things that go on in the background of these types of events that superheroes in the background who are saving the day with technology is, something that's not visible. And it all looked pretty seamless on the surface.
Right.
The background, there was a little bit of juggling going on. And some pretty good heroics, but it all worked out really, really well.
What a fun 24 hours.
It really was. It was, it's easy to stay awake when someone on the screen is telling such a compelling story.
Uh-huh.
So that happened every time I was in the mix. As I say, I napped here and there. And again, the hosts that were working, Carolina from Poland, Alec Tarkowski's colleague, and all the hosts were really super great.
Well, this, it just, I know I've said it before, but that 24-hour webathon was such a unique idea, and it just, it totally blew us away at the depth, the breadth, the magnitude, the speakers, the involvement. It was quite an event, and we thought it was worth mentioning and highlighting again, and we want to put some links up so that everybody can go back and visit some of the webinars that happened during your 24-hour period, and we will do that. But Jenny, I want to thank you so much for your time to do this quick interview so that we could share the work that you did during Open Education Week. We appreciate it and look forward to next year.
Great. Thank you, Susan. It's my pleasure to talk about it. And it will absolutely happen next year. I'm looking at more hands on deck, a little more savvy planning in terms of how the links and the hosting works. And definitely, you know, working hard to attract the amazing work that's happening in the Global South so we can hear more about it.
Well, and we look forward to working with you. We look forward to planning with you. So let us know what we can do.
Okay, great. Thank you so much, Susan.